O'Neill Outside is presented each week by Rockwell Tools, when quitting is not an option.
Hello again, everyone. I'm O'Neill Williams, and welcome to our program. Are you a fly guy? I am from time to time, really. And one of the very best mountain trout streams on the whole east coast of the United States is a place called the Socquie River. And I'm going to take you there several trips to Black Hawk fly fishing. Great food, great lodging, and maybe the best trout fishing on the east coast. I visit there often, and you'll see it today on O'Neill Outside.
Slowly moving up. We'll see if one wants to come up for us or not.
Our guide here at Black Hawk is John Rice. He's a full-time guide on the river, and we are in a spot right now that we're going to go subsurface with.
Well, we're still going to stay on top some.
Okay.
And we're going to stay with, this is a Fat Albert, which is basically kind of a hopper imitation.
Okay.
It's tied in with the foam, and as you see, the rubber legs, so it has good movement in the water and such. Rather large fly, makes it very visible.
I see that.
Makes the take kind of obvious, so you know right when to set that hook. We had a little rain yesterday, as I was telling you, and some hail, which, of course, that basically put some ice in the river and dropped our water temperature just enough. We'll have to see if they're still wanting to come up to the top or if we're going to have to go subsurface. 90% of the time, we have to fish nymphs and fish subsurface. But, you know, when we can get them on top on dries, it's the crème of the crème.
We're going to give it a shot at that.
Now, we're going to give it a shot. We're gonna let
I
try
showed
it
up
first.
With my Fenwick HMX 5-weight, 9-foot, and I've got a weight forward line and a 3X tippet. These are big fish. When you make reservations here at Black Hawk, and they're open year-round, I presume. I didn't ask that question.
Except for July and August.
Okay. Yeah, that's when the water gets too hot.
Kill the fish. It gets too warm. We don't want to hurt the fish.
They've got the waders, the boots, the rods, the reels, the guides, the bugs, the droppers, the expertise, and everything. So the stream is right there behind us. Are these native trout that were born in this river?
Yes.
Okay.
We have natural reproduction in here.
Go up river and tire yourself out. Oh, look at the size of that guy. Oh, look at the size of this guy. Okay, how big is it, John?
23 and a half. Might go 24. I believe he had the dropper.
Yeah, he got lassoed when he got over there.
He shook us.
Black Hawk fly fishing, Clarksville, Georgia.
There you go. There's brown trout.
O'Neill Outside, brought to you by the Whitetail Institute of North America, the GameSaver Food Saver Vacuum Sealing System, the Boat U.S. Foundation, serving the nation's boaters, and Southern Link Wireless Communications Network.
Today you will see me fishing along with several guests on the Socquie River, which just proves you don't have to be fabulous at it, and it's an accommodation for everyone. 20-inch rainbows. What's the name of this spot?
This is the Hemlock Hole. It's named after the huge hemlock tree down here.
Right here?
We're just gonna sneak in. Let's just sneak in right here. Watch the poison ivy on the right.
Leaves of three, let them be, right?
You got that.
Right, sir.
There it is. There it is.
Got it. Boy, these things are like rockets. Now, what am I using, Andy?
This is a terrestrial, a beetle.
Beetle.
Beetle pattern.
Yeehaw!
You got a little rainbow trout. Never want to touch them with a dry hand because you'll take the slime off them. But you can see this is a pretty healthy rainbow.
Oh, he's beautiful.
16, 17 inches.
And we caught him on?
We caught him on a beetle.
Okay.
On the top. With the water temperature being what it is, it's in the mid-60s, which is getting up there. We always want to keep that fish underwater. If you want to take a picture, we just lift them up like that and let her right back down.
We're ready to fish the same hole, or you want to change?
We might want to change a little bit, and then we could come back, because we had a lot of fish in that run, and they were very active. We saw them moving around.
All right.
We'll let them settle for a second. We'll go over here.
You're good at this, aren't I?
It takes a while, and these fish will eat and spit that fly so fast and make your head spin. See this fish moving around right there?
I see him.
Okay. He's milling around looking for something.
He's looking for something to eat. That's a bigger fish. Oh boy, it's a whopper.
Keep her nice and high, bro.
You don't rush these fish. What size hook is it?
These are on a size 14. I don't like to use really big hooks, because if they get in too far in the mouth, they can get the gill raker and they can bleed out. Well, aren't you a talent? Look at that. Yes, sir.
You don't have to really be great to catch them right here.
Right here, there's so many, but you know what you did?
You got
a brown now.
Oh, I got a brown.
Got a rainbow, so we can show the viewers the difference between the two trout. Notice how he just fights and fights and fights.
Look at the guy swimming next to him. You got the drag set perfectly, I will tell you that. So you're telling me the first fish that I missed was your fault?
It was my fault, guide error. If anything goes wrong,
it's your fault.
It's on me. This is a male brown, and you can see the difference.
How can you tell it's a male?
Because the hook jaw. See how thin this is, and how that jaw comes up and hooks.
I see.
That's it. That's how you tell. September and October, that'll become a little more pronounced, and the colors will be a lot more vivid.
This is fabulous.
Isn't it fun?
It's absolutely fabulous.
I have more fun doing this. Okay.
And again, the fly is a...
It's a terrestrial called a beetle. It's a Japanese beetle. Uh-huh. And it works good at this time of year when it's getting warm.
All right, last question. How old is that fish probably?
Probably 2 years.
2 years?
Maybe two and a half.
Okay, let's let him go. I'll bet you're no stranger to the fact that fishing and mosquitoes go together. Water, warm weather, blah, blah. Here's a way to carry your mosquito repellent with you always when you're fishing. It's called a bug band. See the package right there? And you wear it on your wrist. It's a natural repellent that occurs in the stem of a flower, a geranium. Bug band. And here's something else. They come in little packages like this. They're wipes, and you don't have to carry a bottle. Just put one of these in the boat, in your pocket. You can rub it around your neck, your wrist, your arms, your ears, and you're protected from mosquitoes with the bug band or the bug band wipes. And that is your True Turn Tackle Tip of the Week today.
This portion of O'Neill Outside is presented by your Southeast Toyota dealer, O'Neill Outside Signature Sunglasses from Solar Bat, Bojangles Chicken and Biscuits, and Year One Muscle Car Parts.
I want you to meet Abby Jackson. She operates and owns one of the most unique fly fishing experiences on the whole East Coast of the United States, Black Hawk Fly Fishing, and you'll be dealing with her even from the first telephone call. I've been watching. You've been getting calls all day, haven't you?
I have, it's been great.
Yeah. Give me some history. How long have you been in operation?
O'Neill, we have been here since 1995. We renovated this old farmhouse, and we have 2 miles of stream.
Literally thousands of, over the last 18 years, have been here at Black Hawk.
Right.
And so Give me the experience of someone visiting here. Do you have to be an outstanding seasoned trout fisherman?
O'Neill, we get a lot of corporate people here, so we rent out Sims, waders, boots, rods, and we have professional guides, so they can take anybody that has never had a rod in their hand and get them on big fish, average size, 22 inches plus.
I can testify that, and I'm no great trout fisherman. I get to, the only place I go trout fishing is here.
Wow.
So, even if you're not a seasoned trout angler, you're going to catch probably your lifetime trout. Once you get here and you get down to the stream, you're going to see it light up with 200 fish at a time, rainbows and browns over 20 inches. You're going to think, this is paradise, and indeed it is, especially with lunch and dinner.
That's right, all farm to table.
It's a wonderful experience, fishing the Sequoia at Black Hawk.
See how they're moving around, how their behavior has changed?
Yes.
Oh. There you go, there you go, there you go. That's a brown, isn't it?
Yep.
I guess I need to get down here, don't I?
Okay.
Oh Lord, what a fish.
Nice brown. Head first, but don't, wait till I see if I can pick him up. Okay, there we go, turn. Okay, he's going down in.
Going down
the
river?
Yeah, he jumped the pool.
Here I come.
Okay. Come here, big guy. See, he's got the...
Oh!
Beautiful. Well done.
Here, let me hold this and you do your thing here,
okay,
all right?
Okay, let's get this out of his mouth.
Okay. 20, 20, 22?
Yeah, 21, maybe. Nice hefty fish. You see
brown
those teeth?
Brown trout, huh?
You see those teeth in there?
Yeah.
It's pretty color.
Beautiful, beautiful fish. Beautifully done.
Okay, what we're doing is letting the fish get back to a normal rate of breathing because he fought hard. Browns, are not as afraid of humans as rainbows are. They're very timid, so the browns will sit right in your hand, usually until they're ready to go.
Oh, and then he'll flick and go.
And then he'll flick his tail a little bit, and you just let him go. We want to catch this fish for a couple more years for sure. There we go.
Now, this week's Big Green Egg Wild Game and Fish Recipe.
Once you own a Big Green Egg, you're going to notice all the wonderful, wonderful accessories. And one of the accessories is a red cedar planks. Now, I have some rainbow trout, red cedar planks, 375, directly over the grill. And it adds a very, very special flavor. And while that's cooking, I'm going to make a sauce. And it's lemon juice and pepper and garlic and all those wonderful things that we always use for our sauces so that it's not just fried fish. And once this gets up to the proper temperature, which will not take very long, we will put this over the cedar planks for a fabulous rainbow trout on red cedar plank meal. And I'll probably say that dozens of times before we're done. And when you try it, you'll say it dozens of times also. It takes about 15 minutes on the cedar planks, on the egg, and then let's add a lemon dill sauce. Oh, wow. Rainbow trout on a cedar plank. If you haven't tried it, please do. Don't just fry the trout, really make it special on the egg there for 15 minutes. Want the recipe? You can get it. It's not complicated. O'NeillOutside.com, BigGreenEgg.com, Big Green Egg. The ultimate cooking experience. You will witness the cedar flavor in the trout.
There's more O'Neill Outside coming up. But first, let's thank these sponsors. Works PowerShare, Share batteries, save money. Enforcer FireAid 2000. Don't fight fires, extinguish them. Fisher's Choice canned baits. The Georgia Department of Tourism and Economic Development. And by Tough Shed, the premier builder of sheds and garages. Check them out at toughshed.com.
All right, so we're going up to this ledge?
That's correct.
I'll let you lead the way here since it's your water.
All right, you're going to want to be just left of that run, kind of over here in this foam. Feel free to cast away. All right, that's good. Great, now watch it.
Oh, it hit the bobber. You're right, that's a very slow.
Stick him, oh yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
I take direction well.
Fantastic.
That's a pretty fish.
Ooh. Uh-oh. Come here, sweetheart. Excellent. There you go.
That's a pretty fish.
Gorgeous. Starting to color up nicely.
Yep. Boy, thump.
Thump. Very nice. Oh, yeah.
You called that.
How about that hook set, though? And in this river, with how cool the water stays in the summer,
yep.
These fish are just so full
healthy.
Of life.
Yeah.
All year
they don't
long.
Get lethargic in the summer like
no,
a lot of fish,
not
do
at
they?
All. I've been with Abby here at Black Hawk for off and on for about 3 years. And they have been, Abby and John have been just incredible.
Beautiful property they have there.
Oh, absolutely.
So they've got the farm and a kind of a clubhouse, it looks like.
And they take care of this stream like you wouldn't believe.
Now, is this actually private to their land?
This is private.
Wow. So this
is only actually the entire Sequoia River. Look at this fish. Gorgeous. The entire Sequoia River actually begins and ends in this county, in Habersham County.
Really? So this is not a big, long river?
No, not at all. It's give or take a few miles. I think it's about 30 miles long. But the rest of the river, aside from about a 3/4 mile stretch just up the road, is totally private. So this river is very well taken care of.
Ooh.
Oh, this is a big fish. Absolutely. Massive brown.
Come on.
Reel on down, there you go.
Either that or at least like
a
rod. Boy,
she's lethargic.
She really is, it's like a winter fish.
She's pre-spawn.
Oh, is that what it is?
She's full of eggs, man.
There you go.
Yep. Yeah.
That's a mighty big fish.
Whoa. Let me grab this fly out and we're gonna make sure we get a good
wow.
photo out here.
Wow, I'm gonna have to give you my camera to take a shot of that.
For sure.
My God.
Woo!
Oh, she barbed you too, or is that a bite?
That's the brown teeth right there.
Nice.
All right, let's get a good look at her.
Yeah, let's take a quick pick and then let her go. She's a beauty.
Look at this fish, guys. Northeast Georgia brown trout.
That is gorgeous.
Isn't that beautiful?
Thank you, Travis. That was a beautiful fish. Let her go.
Oh, yeah.
Nicely done. Thank you.
That beautiful. Is awesome.
That was beautiful.
You pretty see great. How some of them are real dark?
Yeah, it's amazing.
The black ones, they're almost black.
He said that's pre-spawning colors or something. That's pretty cool. Pretty good day, O'Neill. Thank you for inviting me here.
There's only 200 or 300 of those out there.
Well, I caught like 6 in a row. I thought like I was
Did
a
you?
Fisherman. It was wonderful.
This is Brad's very first trip to Black Hawk.
What a trip. Yeah. I can't believe I'm in Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is really
This
nice.
May be the best mountain trout stream on the whole East Coast.
Pretty nice.
So what do you think?
Too.
The lodging, the food, the fishing, the location. What do you think?
Can we do it again tomorrow?
Yeah, absolutely.
Abby cook for us again too?
Yes, she will.
My
yes,
God.
Yes, she will.
You know, you get the best of all worlds. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
You find all these places to stick an egg,
I
don't
do.
You?
I'm real lucky on that. You're going to be bringing some guys back?
I think so. I've got a buddy who's really anxious to do some trout fishing, and this is a great place to bring somebody. These guys are fabulous.
Yes.
You know, he's
telling
me how
to cast. You don't have to be a fly guy.
No.
To do
I haven't
it.
Thrown a fly on freshwater
in
30 years.
30 years?
Maybe 40.
How many fish did you catch today?
I lost count after 6 or 8.
Yeah. And
Lost
big
a couple.
The biggest one?
5 pounds, probably 22 inches.
Yeah, there you are.
I mean, my eyes are still bugging out over there.
There's nothing like on the whole East Coast.
Except this is nothing like Black Hawk. No, this is a pretty place.
You bet. Black Hawk is it. Brad found out today. Before I leave you today, boys and girls, I have something personal for you. I've been in this business now for 36 years. Can you imagine that? I've come to appreciate my audience, you guys out there that watch the program. So I've done something I hope you'll think is special, an audience appreciation event. You can find out all about it on my website. Hunting gear, fishing tackle, coupons for free goods, grills, rifles, you name it. 58 different very valuable prizes provided by our sponsors. Go to O'NeillOutside.com, find out how to enter. And once you do, you can re-enter every single day. And I hope you take the time to do it. Maybe you'll win something. Probably will. And I'll see you guys next week.